Here we are, another problem with straight talk. Gotta love straight talk. I'm so sick of this. You know, all these cell carriers are a bunch of screw-offs. Just a bunch of rip-offs. So I made my payment. Here you can see the transaction date, the amount approved for, the date that it occurred. I'm going to show you my serial number. But my phone is deactivated when it should have been renewed. So I'm on the little help screen, and the lady's going to pull up my account. Even though the money's been deducted from my checking account, they still deactivated my phone. Nice screw-up, straight talk. You can never get through a customer service live person. You know, you try entering this transaction ID number through the automated thing over dialing, dial 5, you know. It's a joke. They don't want to talk to you. They don't want to deal with you. It's either your phone works or you struggle with the problems and there's no recourse. This is a joke. You know, I hate AT&T. I hate Verizon. You know, I wish Unicell was back in business. Ask if I can get my renewal date, change it a 5th. So I'm disabled, I don't get paid until then, and we're going to see what she says. Basically, I ask her, you know, I got to go through all this headache of going through and reprogramming this. No, she says, thank you for chatting with Straight Talk. If you have any further questions, call a representative. You're right. You can't get a representative through the friggin' automated system if your phone is malfunctioning. What a bunch of shit. Okay, just went through all this automated headache with Straight Talk. My phone was set up for automated renewal through Straight Talk. And my payment was took out on December 30th. Here it is, January 1st, 2015. My phone was not renewed. Here's my dialogue with the representative, Nita. She tells me I have to reactivate my phone. I went through it, dialed the *22, whatever that number is. I can't see it and hold the camera same time. My phone turns back on, and I go to dial my son, and my phone is deactivated. So here I go again for round two, back to Straight Talk. So I got to log in. I got to exit out of this one, but just want to save this conversation here. Straight Talk, a.k.a. Verizon Wireless, whoever else is involved, TracFone, conglomerate thing here. You guys suck. So here we are back to Straight Talk again for the second time with Angie, who I've had to say again, my money was taken from my bank. Why did I have to reactivate my phone by dialing *22890? I thought that only reset my phone, and she wanted my phone number and things like this. So, you know, I'm just so sick of Straight Talk. You know, all these cell phone carriers, bunch of ripoffs, bunch of scammers. Do they care about customer service? No, customer service is an oxymoron. Okay, so she's basically telling me that *22890 will program the service add on your phone to reconnect your phone to the system for activation. I said, so why doesn't it work then? And of course, she's typing back. Let me pause this. She's telling me the activation can take a few minutes, a few hours. Yeah, sort of like when I tried to change my phone number. I had to do it 10 times before it actually reactivated. So I told her, I said, I received a confirmation that it was accepted. A few hours to reactivate is appalling and insane. Let's see what she sends back. She's typing. I think she's in communication with other people, and it lets you know she's typing. So I sent her, isn't automated on your end? Should be. Should be instantaneous. Shouldn't have to take hours. So basically, she tells me that I need time to go through that. If I tried calling a number and received a message that it was programmed successfully, I need to make a call to see if it goes through or not. I said I did, and it says it's deactivated. That's why I'm here again. And it says it was already updated on our end, and however, the programming must be done on your phone. Okay, let me check further. Well, check. So I replied, please, something is wrong somewhere, even though I can't type fast, fat finger typing. Okay, so she says, okay, please allow me a few minutes again. And I said, okay, I'll wait, and don't disconnect me here like Nita did last time, which is rude. Oh, yeah, look. She has exited conversation. Yeah, because they know they can't do anything. They're just taking your money and scamming you. But let us disconnect you. End the conversation. You're out of my limit. My tolerance. I don't want to deal with it. No such thing as customer service. Now I have to give her my serial number or ISN number, which she has in the system. So there it is for the whole world to see. Because she can't copy and paste, so I just typed it in again. Apparently I had a number wrong. She should have that information. Okay, so Angie did it. She reset it on her end again twice. Had me power through it. I went through the thing powering on. Waited 2 minutes, etc., etc. Now I'm asking her, after I told her many, many things, is there a way I can file a complaint against Nita, who dropped me like a hot potato and never followed through with the customer service, to make sure at least my phone was working instead of just dropping me ever so rudely. I'm not sure if that's the kind of customer service Straight Talk wants, but at that point I was about ready to call my bank, cancel the dispute the transaction, throw this phone in the garbage, and go to AT&T or something, or Nextel, who knows, but with no customer service. This is your only customer service, Straight Talk Online. You cannot get to a live person through the automated thing, the 1-877 number that they like you to call. You can refill your card that way if you have a credit card or a PIN thing, but it's insane. And of course, my session is about to expire, even though I'm working with this lady. Excuse me for doing that. I had to click on the tab, keep this session alive, or otherwise I would have been disconnected from Angie. She seems like the only intelligent customer servicer up there. So, Angie, if you ever see this, thank you, and Happy New Year. She's happy that my phone is working, but, she's not going to file a complaint against her cohort, Nita. Nita, that miserable biatch. So I even responded, me too, but I'm appalled she had no sincere interest to help me make sure my phone is working. She shouldn't be doing customer service work. So let's see if Angie types anything back. See how good of a Straight Talk rep she is. Okay, she says, yes, I understand we will take note on the previous representative and then further escalate it. So I replied, being an ass I am, and who will be notified? This conversation will be placed on YouTube in case it never gets reported then. Seems appropriate. I'll send her a note. Happy New Year. Goodbye. Thank you for chatting customer service, and she left the conversation. Happy New Year to you too. Thank you, Angie. At least this woman was decent enough to stick with me and work through the conversation. That's what a customer service rep should do, instead of dropping you because, oh, it's over their head, that she might actually have to do some work. And of course, it's left a session.